Yeah. So the first question on your screens. Please give the answer to me personally in the chat box. Okay, I can see a few answers coming. Srishti, please recheck your answer. Khushbu, please recheck your answer. Okay, Srinath. Please try everyone. Okay, don't worry about right or wrong. You should try everyone. I need the answer from, so here we have 12 students. Everyone should give the answer. Anumitra, Sajal, so many people. I'm still waiting for your answer. So let's discuss the concept and then we will discuss the answer to this question, right? Basically, there are two kinds of interest rate. So if you see as a citizen, we have two type of transactions with the bank. Either we deposit the money. So someone is having the background noise. Please mute. Everyone, please mute yourself. Sajal, please mute yourself. Another is the Another transaction we do is we take the loan. So from the perspective of citizen, the interest on the interest rate on the deposit is called deposit rate. And interest rate on the loan is called borrowing rate. This is from the citizen's perspective, citizen's view. Now the same rate from the perspective of bank. So bank is actually accepting the deposit. So this is called deposit rate from the perspective of bank also. And the amount which is given as a loan by the bank to the citizens, this is called as the lending rate. Now, deposit rate is the deposit rate that is basically that how much bank is giving to the citizen on the deposits. Okay. Lending rate is how much the bank is charging from the customers. So here we are talking about this lending rate. And this lending rate, this is regulated. Why this is regulated? Because in the absence of regulation, if there is no regulation, then bank start using their discretion, and there used to be trend where the bank used to give the very cheap loan to the big corporates, because the big corporate, they have good credibility, they can return back the loan, and the chances of default are less, right? So they will give this loan at a cheaper rate. But the same loan they will give to the poor people at high rate of interest. So this is actually creating inequality. This is basically not justified. Just because bank have the discretion, they are charging as per their discretion, keeping in mind their own interest rather than the interest of the social welfare. So to control this, the RBI has given the mechanism of base rate. So base rate is basically the minimum lending rate that below this, the bank cannot charge from any customer. Be it a prime customer. Prime customer means customer who has very good credibility, or be it non-prime customer. That is the normal customer, right? So this is the minimum lending rate. And basically in case of base rate or in any regulated rate, RBI gives the method. RBI will tell the methodology which is to be followed. But it is the bank, the individual banks, PNB, SBI, HDFC, ICICI, they will calculate the lending rate based upon this formula. So this is very important. You have to clearly understand. RBI is a regulator. RBI decides the repo rate. It decides reverse repo rate. It decides the methodology of the lending rate, not the lending rate. Are you clear? So initially there was base rate. This base rate, in this base rate, the problem was that there was no linkage with the repo rate. Like base rate used to be calculated as per the cost of fund. What is cost of fund? Suppose we talk about HDFC. So HDFC has got the deposits of rupees 1000 at the rate of 5%. That means its cost is 5% plus operational cost of staff plus other cost, for example, cost of CRR. So it keeps, for example, 8% base rate. So primarily the base rate, the lending rate is calculated on the factors other than the repo rate. Now, the problem is that if RBI, what is the primary role of RBI? The primary role of the RBI is to control the money supply. So if RBI want to control the money supply, then what instrument does it have? It has various instruments like open market operation, repo rate, and so. So here we are talking about repo rate. If RBI changes the repo rate, then there is no impact on the lending rate. And because there is no impact, then even because of repo rate, the RBI cannot change the money supply, because money supply somehow will depend upon the lending rate. How money supply will depend upon the lending rate? Because if the lending rate is less, then what will happen? The demand of funds will be more. It will increase or decrease money supply. Please tell me. Are you following me, everyone? Money supply will increase or decrease? Please reply in the chat box. Money supply will increase or decrease? Reply in the chat box. Everyone, please be fast. Increase, absolutely. It will increase. And vice versa. Okay. So lending rate is actually impacting the money supply. And if RBI, going back, if RBI want to impact the money supply, then it should have some control over the lending rate. But in case of base rate, there is no linkage with the repo rate. Are you able to enter in this point? Why repo rate is not useful? Why repo rate has to be abandoned?
Yes, sir.
This is why the repo rate was abandoned. So after the repo rate, we started marginal cost of funding based rate. This is called MCLR based lending rate. So in case of marginal cost of lending based rates, what we are saying, as compared to base rate. So in base rate, what happened? This minimum lending rate was based upon the historical cost of fund. Historical means the funds generated in the past. So in the past, the fund may be generated at a higher interest rate or lower interest rate. For example, before COVID, the rate of interest used to be very high. So the cost of fund was very high before the COVID. Right? So in case of base rate, the cost of fund was based upon history, and therefore the lending rate was also based upon history. The fund which was raised in the past, the deposit which were accepted in the past. But in case of MCLR, we are saying marginal. Marginal means additional. Marginal cost of lending rate. So in this case, what is happening is, whatever additional or new or fresh funds are being raised by the bank from its depositors, the cost of that will be considered as cost of fund for the calculation of cost of fund. So cost of fund is not based upon the history. It is based upon the present. It is very closer to the RBI rates, right? It is close to the RBI rates. It is close to the RBI rates, right? So that is why this was accepted. So it is better than the base rate, but still it has a problem. Can anyone tell what is the problem? Yes, please.
Sir, please repeat again, sir. Base rate. What is base rate?
What is base rate?
Yes, sir.
Base rate is basically the minimum lending rate. It is the rate below which the bank cannot give the loan. That means if base rate is 5%, then to any customer, the lending rate cannot be below 5%. It can be 5%, 6%, 7%, 8%, but it cannot be below 5%. Otherwise, what will happen? HDFC will give loan to Ambani at 1%, and it will give loan to you and me at 10%. Because it will try to, you know, ease its business. वो चाहेगा कि मेरा business आसानी से हो जाए. इतने सारे loan में क्यों देने पड़े? अंबानी तो वापस कर ही देगा ना future में. अंबानी is a good person. Clear? So to control yes, this, there is a base rate, regulated rate, and better than base rate we go to the MCLR. But in case of MCLR, again, it is the cost of fund. The problem with the MCLR, again, it is the cost of fund. So the calculation of the cost of fund is, again, you know, although there is a method, but still it is cost of fund. It is not still our repo rate. So many times what happens, even though the repo rates are changing, RBI want to change the money supply, but MCLR is not changing with the corresponding speed. So the change of speed of MCLR is not as per the monetary policy of the RBI. That is why now we have external benchmark based lending rate. So now this is primarily based upon repo rate, and there are other factors also apart from repo rate. So now the bank can decide the repo lending rate as an association, you know, in correspondence to the repo rate. For example, repo rate was 1% or plus 2%, like that. Okay, so let's see these things in detail. Is it clear, everyone? So far I have given a broad idea. Don't worry, we will see in detail all of these things. Are you clear so far?
Yes.
Okay, yes, very good. Wonderful. So coming back, now you will be able to understand this PPT much better. So base rate. Yeah, so this base rate, sorry. We have cost of fund. How it is calculated? Cost of fund plus margin. Margin means profit. Now, bank exists for some profit, but will make its own profit. Operating expenses. Operating expenses means staff expenses, administrative expenses, running expenses, rent, and so on. And last we have CRR. Can anyone tell why this CRR is here? Can anyone tell why this CRR is here?
For emergency situations, when the bank goes bankrupt.
No. Why this CRR? Why we are taking the cost of CRR in base rate? That is my question. We are calculating base rate. We are calculating minimum lending rate. So we are taking cost of fund. कि हमें कितने पैसे में fund मिला? हमें कितना profit रखना है? हमारा कितना खर्चा हुआ? हमने ये तीन चीजें add करी. सो दैट कि हम लैंडिंग डे डिसाइड कर सकें. लेकिन ये सीआरआर की कॉस्ट कहां से आ गई? सीआर व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ सीआरआर कॉस्ट? यस स्टिलिस्टी यू आर राइट, आरबीआई चेंजेस सीआरआर टू कंट्रोल द सप्लाई, बट व्हाई दिस कॉस्ट ऑफ सीआरआर इज हियर इन द बेस रेट? Anyone would like to try? Because it is because it is used as a policy tool, that's fine. But my point is, in calculation of minimum lending rate, what is the cost of CRR? Why it is a cost? It is a reserve, na? Why it is a cost? Anu Mitra, you are right. It is the amount of money with the central bank. That is fine. Everyone knows that. My question is a bit different. My question is, what is the cost of CRR? By the way, I discussed this concept last year and there are 2-3 people. Okay. Anyways, let me tell you. So, do you know RBI keeps the CRR, but RBI do not pay an interest? राहुल काफी लेट बताया आपने. यू आर राइट बट यू आर वेरी वेरी लेट. सपोज इट इज एचडीएफसी कीप द सीआरआर ऑफ 4% विद आरबीआई. आरबीआई डू नॉट गिव एनी इंटरेस्ट रेट बट when HDFC raised this money from its customers, from its depositors, it is paying the deposit rate. So it has a cost, but this cost is not being reimbursed by the RBI where this money is lying. Therefore, this cost of CRR, it will also be added in the minimum lending rate because it is to be recovered from those people who are taking the loan from HDFC. Did you get it? Please, everyone tell me. If you don't get it, then I can tell you through some other example. Please reply in the chat box, everyone. Yes, no. Okay, wonderful. So this is a simple logic, okay? Nothing else. Life is very simple. No complication. Yeah, so that's why we are including the cost of CRR here, because the bank is paying for this fund but not receiving from the RBI. Okay, so in case of base rate this happens, and in case of MCLR we have marginal cost of fund. What is the meaning of marginal here? Additional cost, the cost of the new fund. Okay, and here it is the total, means old plus new both, which is very very away from the RBI repo rate. It is still closer to repo rate. It has a tenor premium. Tenor premium means basically the longer the duration of the loan, the risk is less or more. If the duration is less, sorry, if the duration is more, the risk is more or less? Please tell me. If the duration is more, the risk is less or more? Please tell me. The risk is more. Obviously, if I give you a loan of 1 year, my risk will be only for 1 year. If I give you the loan for 10 years, my risk will be with you for 10 years. So my risk will become more. So the longer duration loan should be having more interest rate. This is called tenor premium, means there will be extra premium, means extra interest rate for the longer duration loans. This is the meaning of tenor premium. Okay. Operating expenses remain same and CRR remains same. The margin is automatically included in the tenor premium only. So tenor premium ke andar ye margin mein include kar lete hain. Okay. So what is the change between base rate and MCLR? Here it is total cost of fund, here it is marginal cost of fund. Here it is margin, here it is tenor premium. So this is how we calculate the lending rate of the loan. And these are the various components of the base rate and the MCLR. So base rate, it was applicable from 2010 to 2016. You don't need to remember the names. And it is applicable from 1st of April 2016. So at present, we have the applicability of MCLR plus external benchmarking based lending rate, EBR. So in some categories, EBR is compulsory. And in other categories, MCLR is compulsory. So gradually, in phased manner, we are implementing EBR. We are shifting from MCLR to EBR. Gradually, right? So here, following the repo rate cuts, the lender may take a long time to reduce the loan interest rate, because the lending rate is not based upon repo rate. Here it will take less time. Okay, right away to galat dikhawa, it will take less time. Right away agar ho gaya fir to baat hi nahi hai, baat hi kya hai. So benefit of rate cut do not go down, do not trickle down. And here the benefit actually go to the customer quickly as compared to the base rate. What is margin? Srinath, margin is basically profit, right? Margin is profit. For example, Diademy is providing you the classes, right? So suppose the cost of classes is 9,000 rupees. And I charge 10,000 rupees from my students. So 1,000 rupees is my margin or profit. Similarly, in case of bank, similarly, in case of any business, this profit or margin is there. Okay. So here you can see operating expenses, CRR, you can read it later on. I will share the PPT. You can read it later on. I have discussed all of this very clearly. So MCLR, minimum interest rate, it is internal benchmark rate. The bank will calculate itself from April 2016. And tenor premium, it is based upon different type of customer as per their riskiness. Okay, this was one of the statement. Okay, and RBI decided to shift from base rate to MCLR because the rate based on the MCLR are more sensitive to change as compared to the base rate, and it facilitates monetary policy transmission better. What is monetary transmission? Monetary transmission means if RBI is cutting the repo rate and it want to increase the money supply, then it will flow from the RBI to the citizen very easily. That is called easy monetary transmission. Otherwise, it is difficult monetary transmission, right? So here the answer is option A. Statement 2 is wrong because there is not single benchmark rate. The benchmark rate differ based upon the tenure. I told you, the more the duration, the more is the risk, and therefore more will be the lending rate. And RBI decided to shift from base rate to MCLR because the rates based on MCLR are more sensitive to change as compared to the base rate. Okay, so it is not less, it is more. Clear everyone? Those people who did a mistake, you can find out why it was a mistake. By the way, the questions nowadays are coming conceptual, so this standard is the standard of UPSC. you can expect this type of question from the in the UPSC. They're asking the conceptual questions. Okay, so yeah, please practice this question. This is the next MCQ. Hi everyone, I have got only four answers. At least you must try. Don't worry about right or wrong answer. Four people have replied the answer. Okay, I can see everyone has given the correct answer. The correct answer is option C. So this is external benchmark rate. That means earlier it used to be internal. It was calculated by the banks itself based upon the formula given by the RBI, which has four component MCLR, right? Now it is external. That means the benchmark will be external. So what is the difference between the MCLR and EBR? It is also called as repo linked, external benchmark linked, or repo linked. So it is linked to the bank's cost of fund. MCLR is still linked to the marginal cost. So it is the cost of fund, but EBR has no relation with the cost of fund. It is based on the RBI's lending rate, that is a repo rate. This is based upon the repo rate, not upon the cost of fund of the bank. It takes 4 to 6 months to move. Okay. So if there is high inflation and RBI want to change the repo rate, it will take 4 to 6 months to bring impact on the economy, to control the prices in the inflation. But in case of repo linked rate, it will respond immediately, means maybe within couple of weeks only. Within couple of weeks, the impact will be visible. In case of RBI rate cut, the benefit is not passed to the borrower, because borrower will be charged as per the cost of fund of the bank. No benefit, even if the RBI is reducing the rate. And here it is automatically passed on. It is changed annually, normally. So you can understand, एक साल तक कोई change नहीं होता, इसका मतलब कोई भी monetary policy में transmission नहीं possible. But it is reset every 3 months, quarterly. Right? These are the important points: low volatility and high volatility. So all new floating rate, personal or retail loan, anyone? Can you please tell what is the meaning of floating rate? Anyone, can you please tell what is the meaning of floating rate?
Sir, with changes.
Changes with what? Yeah, I got it. It is definitely floating means changing. It is variable. Flexible. Okay. Yeah, basically the rate of lending can be two types. One is flexible, one is fixed. Fixed means irrespective of what is happening in the market, the rate of auto loan will be 8%. Okay. Whether repo rate is increasing or decreasing, but the car loan will be at 8%, that is fixed. But if we talk about floating means the bank has a understanding with the customer that the interest rate will keep changing from time to time. That is called floating rate. So all the new floating rate, personal or retail, okay, for example housing, auto, and the floating rate loan to the micro and small enterprises extended by the banks from October 1, 2019 shall be benchmarked. Means all the loan in these few categories. Personal loan ho gaya, ya retail loan ho gaya, ya MSME ko loan ho gaya. And which is a floating rate. If it is a fixed rate, then it will not be. So these will be Yeah, floating with 4x. No, Anumitra, it is not. Floating, it is not the floating with 4x. It is the floating with the market interest rate, right? And they set a benchmark. This benchmark can be policy repo rate, that is the RBI policy repo rate, or it can be Government of India 3-month treasury bill yield. We have discussed the meaning of yield. We have discussed the meaning of treasury bill in the previous class. So anyone would like to tell what is the meaning of yield and what is the difference between the yield and the coupon rate? I want to check your understanding from the previous class. Srishti, you would like to try?
Yes, sir. Sir, yield is what we what the depositor gets in benefit after the time period completion, and this coupon bond coupon rate is the amount on face value which the issuer gives it to the investor.
Absolutely, very good. So yield is basically the total income to the investor as a percentage of the total investment done by the investor. Right? So yield is calculated. In the yield, we consider the total income, whether it is the income of interest or it is the income of change in the price of the bond or treasury bill. Third is 6-month treasury bill. Okay, who will tell me the features of the treasury bill? Who will tell me the features of the treasury bill? What are the important features of the treasury bill? And please, I'm asking the question so that, you know, you can also cross link, and I'm emphasizing those areas which are emphasized by the UPSC. UPSC asks this type of question. They will give you some of the features of the treasury bill and they will ask, is it right or wrong? So I'm not stopping just for the sake of stopping. I'm stopping for a purpose. Features of treasury bill, who will tell? RBI issues on behalf of government. Okay. What is the special feature?
Issued at discount and redeemed at par.
Absolutely. This is an important feature. It is issued at a discount, right? That means the government will say, okay, you give me 80 rupees. So the issue price is 80 rupees and I will give you 100 rupees. So the 20 rupees is the benefit to the customer, the investor. So this is the unique feature of the treasury bill. It is never giving any coupon rate. There is no coupon rate. Treasury bill mein koi coupon rate nahi hai. Sirf yahi hai jo income investor ko aati hai, right? What is the difference between the treasury bill and the cash management bill?
The cash management bill is issued for maturity less than 91 days. And for the treasury bill, it is 91 days, 182 and 364 days tenure.
Yes, absolutely. So it is the difference of the tenor, definitely. What is the difference between the cash management bill and the ways and means advance? Did you get my question? Anyone who has not replied so far? Anumitra, you would like to reply? Khushbu, Priyanka Nayak, Raj Shekhar,
so ways and means advances has maturity of 3 months and cash management bill is for less than 3 months.
Cash management bill is for less than 3 months and ways and means advances.
It is for 3 months, sir. If it extends 3 months, it becomes overdraft.
Yeah. That is one thing. That is a difference of tenor, but the major difference is something else. The major difference is not the time period. Basically, in case of cash management bill, RBI is selling the cash management bill on behalf of the government and taking the money from the public and giving to the government. So the money is being raised from the public. But in case of ways and means advance, the money is being borrowed from the RBI, right? So in case of cash management bill, the money goes from the public to the government, and in case of ways and means advance, the money goes from the RBI to the government, right? Rate of interest decided by RBI plus government for WMA. WMA is like a loan to the government. Absolutely. So here, again, coming back to this slide, external benchmark based lending, RBI policy repo rate, government of India 3-month treasury bill yield, government of India 6-month treasury bill yield, any other benchmark interest rate published by FBIL. Okay, so this is any other benchmark rate. So yield published by FBIL, yield published by FBIL, point number 2 and point number 3, and here the policy repo rate. Okay, the banks are free to offer such external benchmark linked loan to other type of borrowers as well. They have a choice. Okay, a bank must adopt a uniform external benchmark within a loan category. That means if it is the loan category of car loan, then the rule will remain same for the car loan, right? Yeah, so the next one is banks are free to decide the spread over the external benchmark. However, credit risk premium may undergo change only when borrower's credit assessment undergoes a substantial change. Means the banks can actually they can also add something. Spread basically means kind of extra interest, okay, depending upon the credit risk and all. The interest rate under the external benchmark shall be reset once every 3 months, right? So it is a quarterly changing parameter, right? This is important. 3 months mein change hota hai ye. So here the answer is the wrong answer is option C. Okay, so it is not the long term, it is the 6 month. Financial Benchmark India Private Limited, there can be a question from this also. So it is a company, because it is a private limited, so it is a company registered under the Companies Act, right? And it is recognized by the RBI as independent benchmark administrator, and it will administer the interest rate and the foreign exchange benchmarks. It's in Mumbai. Secured overnight financing rate. So this is very easy concept. I'll come to this concept later on. These are small concept. I'll discuss later on. Let us discuss the concept of Basel norms. Let us start this. Okay. So before going further, we will take a break of 5 minutes and then we will start. Right. So it is 8:56. We will start back 9:01. So break starts now. 5 minutes.